head the group. The other four walked a little way behind. Except for Pushta, all of them had their necks bowed and their feet seemed reluctant to move ahead. Pushta's predicament was the worst. Even his breath seemed to have ceased. What was he going to tell the people who were waiting impatiently for the court's verdict? What face had he left? These thoughts had left him numb. By the time Pushta even reached the mart, the tired and thirsty people had lost patience and everyone gheraud him, everyone speaking at once.
Pushta, what happened? We won, didn't we?
The case went in our favor, didn't it?
Betas, please, ours, isn't it, Pushta?
Tell us quickly.
Why is your mouth shut?
People began asking one question after another, but Pushta's teeth seemed to be blocking his voice and words just failed him. Seeing Pushta's disinclination to speak in the hearts of the people, the proverbial lizard began to ominously cry, tsuk tsuk. In panic, they began to question his other companions.
What happened, Gopi? Why is Pushta silent?
Did we not win, Shankar?
Arre, Babusha, open your mouth.
Pandari, why have the bastards locked their mouths?
Seeing the growing disenchantment of the people, Pushta could no longer keep silent. A cry slipped out of his mouth.
We have been cheated, my brothers. We have lost. God abandoned the righteous. He was swayed by money.
Hearing Kushta's words, the entire packed capacity mart let out a collective gasp.
What?
Then there was a pin drop silence. It remained like that for quite some time. And then a hubbub began to grow slowly among those dejected people.
Arre, I had warned you right at the start not to get influenced by this fellow's ideas.
He talks big, but lives by begging.
He studied four classes and thinks no end of himself.
Arre, this was all a money-making racket. How do you think he could afford to put proper tiles on his roof?
At first, they whispered. But gradually, the voices of the people began to get sharper. And every word began to be spat out, pup pup, like venom spewed by snakes.
For that very reason, I had said that we shouldn't fall for this fellow's pistachios.
Damn the son of a corpse. Hope lightning strikes his house down. The rogue took the money out of the mouths of our children.
Curse him.
Because of this man, we unnecessarily got into the bad books of Parab.
That's true. And in good times and bad, for work and for business, we would go to his doorstep.
Now, do we have any face to go to his house?
If you live in water, you can't afford to make enemies with the big fish. So what if we took the offerings of the temple? At least he would help us in the time of needs.
This fellow won't be able to help us with even a fart. His salary is barely enough to fill his own belly.
Nobody would pay him any attention in the factory. So he came to the village to become a leader.
Do you remember the Adwaghoshi he spoke when he came to collect money? Now, why has he kept his mouth? Huh? He has filled his pockets, isn't it?
We must investigate into this fellow's actions. He will have to bear the consequences.
For deceiving the village, he must not be permitted to stay in the village. From today, boycott his house.
Pushta just kept listening. The words he heard stabbed at his heart.